I'm still getting a feel for how the surrounding community feels about these type of communities.
Maybe stereotype them a little bit.
It's like dating. Who would you enjoy getting old with?
And I would bet you if you walked down the street, maybe 1 in 100 would know, might know the name and not know what it meant.
I had no idea that there were any around here, and I don't really know much about them.
You know, the more people find out about living like this, I think the more people will become interested in it.
With costs of everything going up, everything's going to have to be a little bit more communal.
I've only seen them in movies and stuff, so I'm sure that that's like glorified in a way.
People think, oh, my child is throwing away their life. Well, maybe not.
The sense that they have for wanting to live on the earth lightly, money has not always been what they've had to give. But they've given everything else they had. I mean, they live quite frugally. They're just quietly going about doing what I think of as the right thing.
One, I think people kind of idealize it. Like, oh, that must be perfect. And I have to say, it's pretty close. I mean, it's really nice. I don't think it could be much better.
And I came here and I was like, wait, who's in charge? And they're like, nobody. And I said, that's great. I want to live there.
You have to want to live in the middle of nowhere. That's thing number one.
I'm Ira Wallace, and I've lived at Acorn since it was founded in 1993.
We decided to just drive around country roads and find a sign that said for sale, and probably spent a year gathering people. Most people aren't coming here for a life. They're coming here for an experience. Mm-hmm. You know, spent a while trying to get on our feet. Many, many years of being broke. And then we bought the seed business. I think we sell 10 times now what it was when we bought it. Hard work and a lot of luck. You know, doing the right thing at the right time and having a combination of people who had the right skill sets to make it a success. The basic things that we share are sort of the federation of egalitarian community values, of income sharing, resource sharing, treating people equally, having a care about the environment. What do we do for fun? Silly things. People like to get dressed up in crazy costumes, and they like to play with the animals. I kind of joke. I'm not sure whether we have a farm or a big petting zoo.
Ambassador to goats is my official title. Values that we do all share that are very important is the idea that, like, if you have a problem with someone, you say something to them and you don't not say something to them. If people don't do that, they don't live here. If you're not getting along with the people that live here, you're not having any fun. Like, all of the fun of living here is the fact that you get to live with 30 of your friends, and if you're living with 30 of your enemies, like, I would just go somewhere else.
That's just probably the greatest feeling of freedom. There's no pressure. There's no bosses. People don't have the stress that people normally have in society. We're not really against anything, but we're for each other, and it works out great. I understand very much that living in an intentional community is not for everybody. On the other hand, I think that our way of life here really does serve as a great model for other people to observe and maybe take a cue or two for living. The cooperation versus competition model.
Everybody in Lexington knows about the hippie commune out here in North Mountain. The only municipal service we have out here is electricity. Living in air conditioning just doesn't appeal to me. My name's Albert Lee Stevens, and my wife and I moved here about 4 years ago. We love it here, and honestly, the thing that strikes me most about being here at North Mountain is my degree of experiencing gratitude. There are so many gifts here. If I bring Ben my chainsaw, he'll look at it, and if he can fix it, by God, he will. The forest provides our firewood. The creek provides the water for the garden. The spring provides the water for drinking.
To me, being here is like being your own boss, being the big fish in the small pond. And I like it. Your time is your own. Every day is Saturday. I don't want to have a $40,000 SUV. So I don't want to have a swimming pool. I don't want to pave my driveway. I don't want to build a $400,000 house. I want my footprint on the world to be a light one. And I think I can do that here.
I'm a vice president of the board of the Healthy Foods Co-op. We do all of our shopping there except for what we produce here, which is mostly truck gardening, which is like cucumbers and carrots and lettuce and tomatoes and that kind of stuff. And of course, that's only in season. So we're integrally involved with the community. There's room for everybody here as long as we take care of each other.
When Mike first brought up the idea of going to a community, I was like, you're crazy. Absolutely not. I don't want anything to do with that. Like, I'm not going to a commune. Like, what? No. So I kind of educated myself a little bit more about it. I realized I'm not into a full-on commune where it's sharing everything, share clothes, share money. People get to say how you raise your kids, all that kind of stuff. It's a little bit too much for me. But what I do really like about community is 80 acres. Come on. We could never afford this. And if we were to afford it, we'd have to work our life away and we'd have to be working 80 hours a week to be able to afford something like this. What community allows you to get is all of this wonderful space. Mike doesn't have to work nearly as much. I can stay home with the kids. We, in exchange for rent, he is assuming the garden internship role. You kind of get free reign of all of this, you know, including the schoolhouse. I like to say that my style of homeschooling is what I call a free-range learning, where most of our learning takes place outside and hands-on. We go and we find a feather and then we research about that. So back through here is the spring. The spring supplies all the water here. We like to say we even bathe in spring water because we do.
We're able to provide the large majority of our food just from the gardens, fish from the pond, I raise chickens for eggs and hunt deer. I don't want to sound too woo-woo, but I am, you know, the place in a lot of ways just because my body is now composed of the things that I've eaten that are just made out of this place. A lot of the stuff that I do for pleasure is also the stuff that I do for work. There's sort of the overlap between our model of intentional community and like the communes. Sometimes people assume it's more of a hippie commune than it really is. So I suppose there are some aspects of that, but I mean, if people have a misperception, I don't really lose anything in that.
If we want to do this, how would we do it? Even though maybe it'll be a little difficult.
Working with and dancing with the weather, the soil, the wind, the rain, of course.
You know, even though we are kind of in the woods, I mean, we have, you know, communications, internet, that sort of stuff.
Kind of reminds me of college, like having, I have like, it's like dorm style.
There is no normal day at Acorn. I might do anything.
And that's one of the interesting aspects of living here, because one day really never does look like the next.
It's just living cooperatively with people, in a way that everyone benefits.
We model ourselves as an alternative way of living to the normal American capitalist society.
We're sort of experimenting with being, you know, a lot more loose to see if in fact we can be nimble and flexible and not drive each other crazy.
I think what is most meaningful is just a real, really true sense and feeling of freedom that I have not felt in a long time.